We begin tonight with more developments in the Osama bin Laden shooting. There are new reports that Osama's 12-year-old daughter witnessed the bloodshed. It's claimed she said he was unarmed when American commandos stormed his room. She says he'd been captured and then shot dead, his body dragged to a helicopter. Late News reporter Dan Sutton is in New York, and Dan, the courts are escalating for proof that Osama bin Laden is dead.
Well, the CIA director has come out today saying he believes those photos showing Osama bin Laden's body will be made public, although he hasn't been able to say when. The final decision, though, rests with the White House, and they haven't made a call on it just yet, according to them. Although President Obama has had plenty more on his plate today, with an admission from his administration that when the United States took out Osama bin Laden, they shot dead an unarmed man. When Navy SEALs shot Osama bin Laden dead inside this compound, the Obama administration declared he was holding a gun. Today, a giant backflip.
He was not armed, is what I understand to be true.
He did, the White House says, resist capture, so the elite team of soldiers discarded their option to bring him in alive.
I'm glad. You know what my regret is? That I didn't put that bullet through his head.
Lynn Linali's brother, Wayne, was inside Tower 1 when the planes hit. She and husband Mario say today's revelation goes some small way to even up the scales of justice for victims.
You think these people were armed when they were killed in cold blood?
Yeah. You know what? Even better. I'm glad he wasn't armed.
The Linalis also want photos of bin Laden's body released, although it's a divisive issue.
I don't think it's a good idea.
You wouldn't want to see it?
No. Who cares?
Yes, I'd like to.
Why?
Just to see for myself.
The CIA director believes they will be made public at some stage. But that proof may be sometime coming, if at all. The White House says the photos it has of bin Laden's body are gruesome. Releasing them may be insensitive. The president is yet to make a decision.
This is an issue that we are taking into consideration, is that it could be inflammatory.
Already, the leader of this Pakistan-based militant group has declared bin Laden's martyrdom will not be in vain. And as life for bin Laden's neighbours returns to normal, the government, kept in the dark about the raid, is desperate to move on.
This issue of the Osama bin Laden, it's history.
At Ground Zero, families say that will never be true. In New York, Daniel Sutton, 10 News.
Debate is now raging about whether killing the world's most wanted man was ethically or legally wrong. Australia's most high-profile human rights lawyer has called bin Laden's death a perversion of justice.
Unarmed and showing no resistance, Osama bin Laden was shot execution style.
It's not justice, it's a perversion of the term.
The White House has corrected earlier statements, now confirming the terrorist wasn't fighting back. International human rights lawyer Jeffrey Robertson says in that case, bin Laden should have been arrested and not killed.
Justice means taking someone to court, finding them guilty upon evidence and sentencing them. And what is now appearing, after a good deal of disinformation from the White House, may well have been a cold-blooded assassination.
Even in a military operation, if you come across a person who is surrendering, he's unarmed, then it would be extremely unusual to kill them.
The US says resistance doesn't require a firearm.
We were prepared to capture him if that was possible. We expected a great deal of resistance and were met with a great deal of resistance.
It was effectively a combat zone. I think people would regard Osama bin Laden as being very much a combatant.
The ethics of openly celebrating someone's death also continues to be questioned.
I think this is a natural and even perhaps understandable reaction from people, but it's regrettable.
For us to welcome news that he's no longer in a position to organise and wreak violence against innocent civilians is the appropriate thing to do.
Osama bin Laden's declared war on them. Why wouldn't you celebrate now that the threat is gone?
With reprisal attacks now at the front of people's minds, the figurehead may be gone, but the threat has not. Melinda Nusafora, 10 News.
Meanwhile, Osama bin Laden's death has continued to draw anger from some of his followers in Pakistan. Around 300 protesters shouted slogans and burnt US flags. They later held a prayer service in honour of the terror mastermind. They've warned that the death of Osama bin Laden will not bring an end to the insurgency.